gonna be a long one, another graveyard shift. As he says goodbye to his wife and kids, it's been his life just like his dad's, driving away under the weight of the badge. He's seen it all in his 15 years, watching our backs, facing our fears. Lord knows it ain't no easy task, keeping us safe under the weight of the badge. He swore that oath to protect and serve, pours his heart and soul into both those words, lays his life on the line, and the line he walks is razor fine. Tempered strength is always tough, but he ain't gonna buckle under the weight of the badge. Not that long ago, he woke up in the hospital with his wife and kids praying by his bed. He said, I'm gonna be alright, there's just sometimes you gotta fight, and the truth is nothing truer could be said. I do it for us, and I do it for them, and I ain't gonna buckle under the weight of the badge.
Service officer badge, his patrolman badge, juvenile badge, investigator, sergeant, and deputy chief. Let me get a picture.
Chief Ruff.
There you go.
Thank you. And today we have a couple different chiefs of the Steger Police Department. First, I'm going to ask Pat Rossi if he can come up and say a few words. I think you probably worked with him the longest, right? 25 years.
So, last night I was thinking about this. My career has been 30 years here in the village plus. Great. Jerry's been about 23 and a half, and I explained to his wife, I don't know how to look at this, because actually we're twins. You may not think so. You may not think so, but everything I've done, who's been behind me? Jerry. We were patrolmen, then we went to their class. Of course, in there, we did a lot of things together with schools and stuff. We did a lot of presentations together and stuff. Then we went, well, I got promoted first. Then he got promoted. I was the administrative sergeant. He ended up being the administrative sergeant. I went to deputy chief. He got promoted to deputy chief. Unfortunately, he didn't have the other 5.5 years to go yet. Who knows where he would have went. But then I'm looking at the one thing that Jerry did come in to the police department with And that was his ability to work with the community, the community relations, which I take it he probably got from Richardson Park writing all the tickets and stuff. But he's like any general police officer who comes in. They go enforce the ordinances, the laws, write tickets, arrest people.
Exactly. We think politicians like to talk, right?
Yeah, I know. You were.
And the only reason why I got you involved in the police and fire board is because Diane asked me to, so.
The truth comes out.
Just kidding. So, Jerry, really what Pat was saying, it is true. Our community really does embrace the police. And that's one of the things that I'm really proud of, is because our community is so supportive. But they would be if it wasn't for people like you, because you have been the face of the department for so many people, because you have been out there just touching everyone's lives. My kids still think you're the chief, because they only know you because of the dare, you know. They you know, you have touched so many kids. Every kid knows your name. Every kid knows your face. Every kid feels comfortable because of you. And that touches and affects our community more than you can ever appreciate. And then we really are going to lose a big piece of our department because of your retirement. And we do have a lot of young people that I hope can fill your shoes, but they're big shoes to fill. You really have done a tremendous job, and I really am going to miss you. And I think that, you know, you have touched us, and it's going to continue on for years. So thank you for everything you've done.
Thank you.
There's some big little shoes to fill. But Pat, you talked about he's got 30 years, he's got 25. I don't have that. I have 1 year here. But I will say it was like a dog year. It was worth about 8 years. 8 years, but I got a call when I was sitting over there on my phone. There's a guy on the other line crying. And that's the guy who owns the shake shop in town. Because every day since I came here at 11:30, Jerry's on his way to get a milkshake. I said, hey, let's go to Burger King or McDonald's. He goes, no, I don't eat that stuff. I eat this homogenous, great milkshake, you know? So I go, well, let me try one of those, Jerry. And nothing against the owner of the company, but after that, I never asked Jerry again. So I would just like to say, as interim chief here, I met a lot and learned a lot about Steger's people, its culture, the police department certainly. But I learned right away how special the DC was. First of all, he said on the first day, he goes, hey, whatever you want to know, let me know. I'll do anything you need to know. What's most important? I said, well, Jerry, the first thing is, where's the men's room? Because I got to go to the bathroom. So we started out there. And it was all uphill. But his dedication is second to none. There's no question about it. We don't always see eye to eye in life with people, and that's just the way it goes. But you couldn't find a better person who gave back to his town. I mean this from my heart, that he grew up here, and he returned tenfold what he was given in this town, thanks to his parents, his wife, his family. He gave it all. And he touched the main thing I believe in life is that when you're, you know, this is a retirement. He's on to the next chapter, but as Pat alluded to, the mayor, it's not what you have in your hands and where you're living and what you got on your wallet ID or whatever. It's how many people in life you touch. That's more important than anything else when it all comes down to it. And I'll tell you what, Jerry's touched as many as I know in this town. And for that, the town, the people here, your officers, they're indebted to you. Thank you for a great career, and I'll give you the best.
We have Dale and Maria come on up.
So, on behalf of the association, I want to give you this card from the association. A couple of guys that have retired also signed it, and that's just our thanks to you for all the years that you led us with the association and your service to the department. Thank you.
Steger,
Steger.
been an honor serving with everyone. Stay safe. 802 is 1042 for the final time.
She will.
Oh, she will.
She'll have to say.
Deputy Chief Ruff began his law enforcement career with the Richmond Park Police Department as a CSO. In 1997, he was hired as a full-time police officer with the Steger Police Department, the village in which he grew up in and lived in. He attended Chicago Police Academy and was one of the top officers in his class. During his career with the Steger Police Department, Deputy Chief Ruff participated in many roles. He was a very active member in the department, riding on bike patrol, running torch run, president of the Police Association, pension board, and the Steger Drug Committee. In his time with the Steger Police Department, Deputy Chief Ruff was a juvenile officer and investigator before being promoted to the rank of sergeant in 2008. In December of 2018, he was appointed as Deputy Chief. Deputy Chief Ruff was best known in the community as a dear officer, teaching dear to countless students of Chicago School District 194 and 20 for 20 years. For 25 years of dedicated service to the village of Steger and its residents. Deputy Chief Ruff, enjoy your retirement and this next chapter of your future. You will be missed. Deputy Chief Ruff, Steger, you will now be for 1042.
We're alike. Twins.
But in the mid-90s, I couldn't do anything without the support from my immediate family, first with my parents and my sister that are here. If I can give them a nice round of applause. There's a lot in this room that bleed blue, and we know today it's tough getting into law enforcement and staying there. And I did that with my family support. And then once I got onto the department, the ups and the downs with shift work and all the things that are sometimes difficult, I got to thank my wife, Erin, if I can give her a nice round of applause. I've got my wife's family sitting back there in the corner. They gave me a lot of support, so I want to thank BJ and Linda for their support. If you've ever visited the station and you came in and saw all those homemade decorations that I had, they came from my boys, and those are my main inspiration. Part of my retirement and what I'm looking forward to, I'm getting to spend time with them. So in the back, and just throughout my career, I got to thank the village, the police department, the school district. I mean, it was a second home for me. I was in there for so many years. Everybody here that bleeds blue. So now with me going 1042, I can say that I grew up in Steger. I went to school in Steger. I worked in Steger, and now I'm retiring in Steger. So thank you.
Send them back off. Just let yourself be free. Oh.
off to work each day, 'cause over the years you've paid.